Board of Commissioners meeting. We appreciate your attendance, and for the viewers, we thank you for tuning in. And for introductions, on my left is Commissioner Deb Shore and Commissioner Todd Wilchin, and on my right is Commissioner Bill Avery, and I am Commissioner Roma Amundson, Chair of the Board. And assisting us right now today, we have Dave Durbin, who represents the County Attorney's Office, Kelly Lindgren and Dan Nolte of the County Clerk's Office, and Carrie Egan, Chief Administrative Officer. So will you join me now in saying the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And thank you so very much. And Mr. Clerk, will you begin the agenda, please?
A copy of the Nebraska Open Meetings Act is located on a wall at the rear of the hearing room. Additionally, a copy of all written material to be discussed at today's open meeting is available from the county clerk's staff. The material can also be viewed on the county's website at lancaster.ne.gov. Agenda item one are minutes. Approve the minutes of the Board of Commissioners meeting held on Tuesday, December 1st, 2015.
Move approval.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve the minutes. Are there any corrections? Please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number two are claims. Approval of all claims processed through December 8th, 2015.
Move approval.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve all the claims processed through December the 8th. And are there any corrections or additions? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number three is new business. 3A is setting the salary of Jordan M. Talsma, Deputy County Attorney, at $60,305.44 as an Attorney 1 in the Lancaster County's Attorney Office, effective December 7th, 2015.
Morning, Doug Sear, Lancaster County Attorney's Office. We're asking you to set Jordan's salary this morning. Mm-hmm. Jordan's a new lawyer in the office. He's actually been in the office for 2.5 years as a law clerk. He'll be going over to the child support division, doing child support enforcement as his first assignment. And Jordan hails from Iowa.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. That was too bad about Iowa.
I know. I get that a lot.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, please?
Sure. Doug mentioned, I'm originally from Iowa, Colfax, Iowa, a little small town outside of Des Moines. I went to the University of Iowa for undergrad, came out here with my wife for law school. I've been working at the county attorney's office as a law clerk since May of 2013, and then took the Iowa bar, got waived into Nebraska just this past Friday, got deputized on Friday, and we'll be starting in the child support division effective yesterday. So.
Okay, well, wonderful. We're glad to have you here. Any questions or comments?
Well, anytime you're working with the children of Lancaster County, you're doing the most important work. So
right.
Best wishes to you. We're glad to have you as part of the team.
Thank you.
Okay.
I would move approval of the salary for Jordan.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we set the salary, that we approve the salary of Jordan Talsma. Is there any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. B is a resolution authorizing the county clerk to issue payments while the county board is adjourned.
Move approval.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve the resolution authorizing the county clerk to issue payments while the county board is adjourned. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. C is a resolution authorizing the installation of two weight limit signs, one for northbound traffic and one for southbound traffic on Bridge E-117 located on Northwest 84th Street, approximately 1/4 mile north of West Bluff Road.
Pam Dingman, Lancaster County Engineer. Okay, so today I'm before you and we are technically downgrading a bridge, which means we are weight limiting this particular bridge. It was damaged during the flooding. It is on a spread footing. It is a cut limestone bridge that was put together during the WPA days. We actually have several of those around the county. And so in this case, because of the spread footing and because of the damage from the flood, we are adding the weight rating to this particular bridge.
What is the weight rating? How much?
I think we only, and I apologize for not having that with me, I think we only downgraded it a couple tons.
Okay.
But again, it's important to be correct. When I weight rate bridges, we do them through the state. Of course, once we get down to three tons is like the lowest weight rating. We do have several bridges like that in Lancaster County. And then after 3 tons is when I feel the need to close them. When they're weight rated, it means that we do inspect them more regularly, and they have a higher maintenance standard.
Pam, do you know off the top of your head, will this affect like school bus traffic with regards to Waverly or Malcolm?
This,
Waverly, I'm sorry,
and this
Raymond.
Will be out in the, not in the Waverly area, but in the Malcolm School District area. It's that 3-ton rating that really gets us.
Mm-hmm.
So again, I think the thing that we have to be cognizant of is the other small bridge that I've closed, we did go from this weight rating to closed. So, when we start weight rating these, it's when we start, we're having dramatic concerns about the structural stability of these bridges, which is why we do this.
Bill?
Would you be willing to comment on how you enforce a 3-ton weight limit?
Well, Commissioner Avery, humbly, as the county engineer, I really have no enforcement authority. That, of course, falls under the sheriff's office. State statute is kind of a little ambiguous there. We have to prove that the vehicle that passed over it weighed more at the time it passed over. And then the fines really are a couple $100. So so it becomes difficult to enforce. Of course, the bridges that I've closed, we've put guardrail across to keep people off of them. I get a lot of calls about signs and additional signage in the county, and I have to always humbly remind people that just because we have a traffic sign doesn't mean someone obeys the traffic sign. So they do become somewhat difficult to enforce. I do think it helps the good law-abiding citizens of Lancaster County be aware, enforcement is difficult.
And it protects our liability too.
And it protects our liability. Of course, if someone does take a vehicle over a weight-rated bridge and there is a catastrophe, that person then becomes liable for the bridge.
I didn't think you were sitting out there with a camera or anything.
Or a scale.
The camera's easy, the scale's hard.
Based on that explanation from the county engineer, I move approval.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve this resolution regarding the 2-weight limit signs. Any further discussion? Please call the roll.
Wiltshire?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. 3D is a recommendation from the purchasing department and a county engineer to award a bid to Valley Corporation in the amount of $92,394.49 for bridge structure D88 bank scour repair project number 15-25.
Pam Damon, Lancaster County Engineer. So of course this is bridge D88 on Agnew Road. It is a federal aid route for Lancaster County. So federal highways will be paying, will be reimbursing us for 80% of the repair costs for this bridge that was badly damaged during the flood. This is a bridge actually that, interestingly enough, we didn't pay for originally. The federal government paid for it because it was on the route to one of the missile sites and it needed to be a big beefy bridge. So when you look at it, it's an interesting bridge in that the piers are actually hexagon poured concrete, steel reinforced cages inside. But during the flood, this bridge, the creek actually changed, it meandered a little bit, and that meander caused the downstream west embankment to erode substantially. In addition to that, there's some natural springs there. So with these improvements, in addition to the sheet pile wall, we'll also be adding a pipe. The pipe is 100% Lancaster County's cost, but I believe that that will substantially help out with this spring that is there. This is the bridge that you may recall I came forward with emergency action on. We were unable to get a response from the emergency action, mainly because there was a shortage of steel this fall. We're hoping that this contractor can get in January and start work on this, because it is work that we can do in the winter, and with the natural springs in the area, it's best to do it in the winter. So I'm keeping my fingers crossed that we don't have a really harsh January. That's where we're at with this one. Any questions?
Move approval of the recommendation from purchasing, the county engineer.
Second.
Moved and seconded that we approve this recommendation by the county engineer. I would like to point out that it is like roughly $92,000, but we're getting reimbursed roughly $73,000.
It is roughly $92,000. It's interesting because the three bidders were not the people that we originally contacted. So we did get some fairly aggressive pricing on this. And so we had estimated this job, I think, at about $120,000. So of course, we're very happy it came in at $90,000.
Oh, absolutely.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Can you explain a little bit about the reimbursement process? You mentioned that this is one of those projects that will be reimbursed.
Right. So this process is a little different than the FEMA process. And I can come back to a staff meeting in a couple weeks and talk about where we're at with all the processes. This process, because it is on a federal aid route, goes through federal highways. So it becomes more of a reimbursement. We do the work, and we file the paperwork with the state, and then they reimburse us. So it's a little different than the FEMA reimbursement process. But they have already agreed. They agreed prior to the bidding of this project. They actually agreed way back when it was an emergency, when I tried to get the emergency approval contract through. They had agreed at that point to reimburse for 80%. They would have reimbursed for 100% in the first 180 days. We didn't make that deadline. I will go back and ask for an extension on that deadline. I don't know if I'll get it, but I think if you don't ask, you're not going to get it for sure. Mm-hmm. So right now we're at the 80% mark with reimbursement.
And so when you say they, you mean the Department of Transportation through the state of Nebraska?
That is correct, Commissioner.
Okay.
Thank you for the clarification.
Okay, any further discussion? Okay, it's been moved and seconded, so please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Abstain.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 3 yes, 1 abstention. Three E is a request from the Human Resources Department to revise the County Records Specialist 3 classification and to change a pay grade from a C09 to a C12.
Good morning, Doug McDaniel, Human Resources. This position comes before you for a grade reassignment after a study and reorganization in the County Clerk's office. The next item, which is the vacancy of the Board of Equalization Specialist, those duties were redistributed to this Record Specialist 3 class and the subsequent grade assignment.
No question? Okay. Mm-hmm. This is the...
Well, okay. I guess this is the position that Deb and I have been working on for several months with the County Clerk to address the electronic records management position.
This is not, sir.
Okay.
That position was approved last month.
Okay.
This is a position which is, I hedge on saying it's below this, but this position assumes all the duties of the Board of Equalization Specialist. It is not the records administrator position, sir.
Okay, right.
It's taking the position that Melissa previously had, and distributing those duties to other members of the County Clerk's office, and as a result their pay grade is being increased because their workload and duties and responsibilities have increased as well. I will move approval.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve this revision of the County Record Specialist and the change of the pay grade. Any further discussion? Okay, please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. F is a request from the Human Resources Department to delete the classification of Board of Equalization Specialists.
Again, as previous action, that position is vacated. The duties have been redistributed to a position in the clerk's office, so we're seeking to eliminate this position from our rosters.
I would move approval.
A second.
It's been moved and seconded that we delete the classification of the Board of Equalization Specialist. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. G is requesting the Human Resources Department to change the pay grade of the Operations Manager classification from an E-19 to an E-20.
This request came from the County Attorney's Office. This is the Operations Manager in the County Attorney's Office. The County Attorney asked us to look at this role. We were able to find four different matches in surrounding counties, which indicated that it does need to be elevated one pay grade.
This is Eileen LeGrand's position. She had basically been topped out for several years in her pay classification. She performs many functions in our office, all the way from the human resource to budgeting to grant management. Eileen's extremely valuable asset in the office, and Joe and I felt that this was justified. We made the request to Doug's office to do the salary survey, and this is what it came back, a one-step pay increase.
And Doug, how long has she served in this position?
She has been here since before I got here. I have 35 years in this month. I think Eileen has maybe 38-ish. I don't know what we'll do if we lose her, to tell you the truth.
She's a valuable, very valuable asset.
She's been through about five county attorneys and kept all of them in line, so. Yep.
I will move approval of item G.
Second.
Moved and seconded that item G, referring to the increase in salary or increase in the pay grade for Eileen LeGrand. It is moved and seconded, so any further discussion? Please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. H is an agreement between Lancaster County and the Nebraska Department of Health and Human Services regarding county clerk's computer access and use of the state's electronic registration system for vital records. Term of the agreement is January 1st, 2016 to December 31st, 2020.
Move approval.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve this agreement. Is there any discussion? Please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. 3I is agreement between Lancaster County and Cash Money 24/7 LLC for providing automated teller machine services. The term of the agreement is 1 year from the date of execution.
Move approval.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve this agreement between Lancaster County and Cash Money 24/7 LLC. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. J is a contract with Hewlett Packard to convert software licenses from HP Trim to HP Records Manager.
Move approval.
Second.
Moved and seconded that we approve this contract with Hewlett Packard to convert the software licenses. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. K is an amendment to County Contract C-13-3 with Mr. Yards and Moore LLC for lawn mowing and maintenance services at the Community Mental Health Center facilities. The amendment renews the agreement for an additional one-year term from January 8, 2016 to January 7, 2017.
Hmm. Are we going to own this building for the next year? I wouldn't think so. And is there ability to cancel it? I mean, in theory, it could be out of the building before the grass grows.
I think that this is also for maintenance services, too.
Yeah, but I think we'll be out of there.
We'll be out of there.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, we would be out of there.
For the grant.
Oh, okay. perhaps what we need to do is to put this on hold and visit
maybe,
with...
Maybe it includes snow removal. I don't even know. So I can bring it up and see how long it's
okay, going. Let's discuss this. Can we put this on hold then?
Yeah, because I'm not seeing anywhere in here. I'm reading the contract. I don't see anywhere where there's a cancellation.
Does it include...
Any language?
Does it include snow removal?
No, I don't see that either.
Is there a cancellation? Okay, let's see
I guess we'll do this.
Yes.
For the county attorney.
Dave Durbin, Deputy County Attorney, County Attorney's Office. If there is a cancellation clause, and there usually is in one of these, it would be in the original contract. This is just an amendment changing the term. I can check into that and get back to the board next
week.
Okay,
why don't we do that? Okay?
Yep. And ask about the snow removal, too.
I would move that we table item K.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that we table item K. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. L is the second addendum to the Lancaster County Visitors Improvement Fund grant contract between Lancaster County and the Lancaster County Agricultural Society to amend County Contract C-13-84 to extend the completion date of Phase 4 of the grant project from December 31st, 2015 to December 31st, 2016.
I would move approval.
Second.
It's moved and seconded that we approve the second addendum, which is an amendment. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
I would just make one point for the benefit of the people watching that the next two items are two items that have no direct impact on the actual cost to taxpayers through the Convention and Visitors Improvement Fund. It's just that because the projects were not completed in time, we need to extend the contract dates.
Yeah, thank you for that explanation. Okay, please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. 3M is a second addendum to the Lancaster County Visitors Improvement Fund grant contract between Lancaster County and the Abbott Sports Complex, Abbott Motocross Park, to amend County Contract C-15-250 to extend the grant term from December 31st, 2015 to May 31st, 2016.
Move approval.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve the second addendum to the grant contract with Abbott Sports Complex. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. N is an agreement between Lancaster County and DeNovo Ventures LLC to provide Enterprise One consulting services related to the J.D. Edwards upgrade project. The project will begin as soon as possible after the date of execution and is estimated to be completed on or around June 30th, 2016. The estimated cost of the county is $237,752.
All right, good morning. Dennis Meyer, County Budget and Fiscal Officer. This contract is really to upgrade our financial system. We went out for RFPs and we went through the process, and this contract here ends up being the lowest bid. Not only were they the lowest bid, they're also the company that worked with the City of Lincoln during their latest upgrade also. For the record, you know, our financial system has not had any type of upgrade since really November 2011, and this upgrade should really set us up for like the next 5-year period. So I'd answer any other questions that you might have.
And there was a training component that accompanies this upgrade?
There is. I mean, there will be a training component really for the technical side for our information services people, as well as our accounting side, which will be done between me, Liz, and Tim, and then we will get that information out to each of the departments from there.
Okay. Based upon that explanation, I move approval of the agreement with De Novo Ventures.
Second.
It's moved and seconded that we approve this agreement between Lancaster County and De Novo Ventures. Any discussion? Yes.
Sir. Could you give us an example of the kind of services that we're talking about? When you upgrade, what are you upgrading?
Well, on this upgrade, a lot of what we're doing is on the technical side. So, you know, from the user side in the departments where we're entering, you know, different types of receipts or doing payment vouchers, things like that, from the user side there shouldn't be a whole lot of changes there. It's going to be maybe more behind the scenes. You know, we are upgrading from 8.12 to now 9.2. So hopefully, along with that, we'll be moving to a new server. We'll be doing a lot of that. So hopefully, from the technical side, you know, we're just better from there. So that we don't have any issues for shutdowns of the system and things like that.
How many hours of training are actually going to be included?
The number of hours, it'll kind of depend as we're going through there, because part of the travel cost also plays into how much training we're going to get, because a lot of that training, they might come on site. So it's going to kind of depend as we're going through there. First of all, you know, if there's not a whole lot of changes to the user side, well, then there's not going to be, you know, there's really not going to be a whole lot of training that's going to be needed. Most of the training will be from the technical side, because our IS people have some knowledge of the JDE system, but it's nothing that they're dealing with all the time. So by going through this upgrade, it also allows them to kind of refresh their knowledge of what's happening, because the JDE system is not, I mean, it is somewhat a complicated system. So any type of help we can get down to IS for training purposes is always a benefit to us.
And you did say this is the lowest bid.
This is the lowest bid.
And I'll just point out that this was discussed at our last Information Service Policy Committee meeting, and Dennis is correct that the city has already gone through this process, and it is the same vendor.
Right.
So.
And same cost?
Yeah.
Our cost would probably be a little bit less than their cost.
Okay, I'm ready to vote.
Okay, please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. 3-0 is reappointment of Martha Scholsky and the appointment of Piyush Srivastav to the Lincoln Lancaster County Air Pollution Advisory Board for terms to expire on September 1st, 2018.
I will on that one.
Move approval.
Second, for the purposes of the discussion with our county engineer.
Mm-hmm. Lancaster County Engineer Pam Dingman. I know there's been some controversy around the appointment to this position, but I just want to say how enthusiastic I am to see Piyush be appointed to the Air Pollution Advisory Board. I've known him as a small business person and as an entrepreneur for about 10 years, and he is really a highly educated expert in this area and a stand-up guy. And you know, when small business people volunteer for these sort of positions, I mean, they're definitely taking away money from their bottom line that they could spend working in or on their business. Rather than dedicating donated time to the city and the county. And so it's very admirable that he has agreed to serve the city and the county. And I just wanted to enthusiastically endorse him for this position.
Okay. Thank you. Move a reappointment of Martha Scholsky and the appointment of Piyush Srivastav.
Motion has already been made.
Oh, and I seconded it.
Okay. So with that explanation, let's move forward with the call of the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. 3P is a request from Connie Duchesne for a refund of real property tax.
Good morning, Scott Gaines, Deputy Assessor, Registered Deeds. I'll give you a little background here and then let the Duchesne speak. When our appraiser was out there recently, we discovered that the Duchesne's own two adjoining roughly three-acre parcels. There's an outbuilding on one parcel and there's a home on another parcel. Our office had inadvertently listed the outbuilding on the parcel that contained the home in error. It actually sits on what we had as a vacant parcel. When the appraiser visited with Mrs. Duchesne, it said, well, that's wrong, and it's been out there since 2012 at least. The refund request is for 2012 through 2015. The statutes limit it to the current year and three prior. What we discovered upon further review is even though that outbuilding had been listed on the parcel that contains the home, there was no additional value that was added to that parcel because of that outbuilding being listed on that property, if that makes sense. Basically, it carried no value. So for the years 2012, 13, and 14, essentially that outbuilding did not add any value to either parcel. So our recommendation is beginning in 15 is when the error actually caused the value to be inappropriately high on the parcel that sits with the home. So our recommendation is to approve a credit for 2015 taxes to remove that outbuilding from that parcel because it doesn't sit there. And the reduction in the value there is about $11,800 for 2015. And the Duchesne's would see a credit in that amount, corresponding tax amount. Now there is a correlating item in the Board of Equalization agenda that will send two notices to the Duchesne's. One to say we're reducing the 2015 value as I just described. Another one that will talk about an increase in the 15 value for the otherwise vacant parcel that we're adding the value to. Now it gets complicated in that it isn't a apples to apples value move. Just based on the way that the appraisal staff values an outbuilding sitting on a vacant parcel versus an outbuilding that sits on an improved parcel. The net effect of this is about $150 in tax, roughly, that will be credited for 2015, and that will get the outbuilding on the right parcel and we'll have it corrected going forward. With that, I'll respond to any questions. And
so we're not dealing with any past years on either side, either the increase or the decrease. Just only looking at 15.
Correct. The law would limit the refunds to 2012 forward. Mm-hmm. What we've discovered is there was no additional value for 12, 13, and 14 on either parcel for the presence of that outbuilding.
Okay.
So we need to fix 15, and the notices that we'll see on the Board of Equalization agenda will correct 15.
Okay.
Yeah. So I guess the structure was built. Is it a recent structure or has it been there for a while?
We built that in 1987.
Okay. So I'm assuming that it was captured during the reevaluation?
That's my understanding is it was discovered and also discovered that it was inappropriately listed on the wrong parcel, even though we weren't having any value associated with it.
And it had been 100% depreciated.
Oh, okay.
You know, the parcels are juxtaposed, so they look like they're all one unit, but they're not. We keep the two separate in case we wanted to build on the second property.
Right.
Okay. Are you satisfied with this?
Yes, totally. Yes. He represented accurately what's going on.
Okay. That's amazing. It was confusing for us to sort out. It's
confusing to hear it. Okay. I will move approval of the request based upon the information from the county assessor's office.
And just technically, it won't be a refund. It'll be a credit of the 15 taxes, and you'll get a corrected tax statement. So.
Okay. Thank you.
I will second that. And you, like you said, the credit will be approximately $150.
I just sketch it. I don't know exactly what the tax rate is there, but in the $150, $175 range is my best guesstimate.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve the request for the refund of the real property tax. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0.
Yeah,
Thank you. We appreciate the help of the assessor's office too.
That's always nice to hear.
Uh-huh. They don't get a lot of praise and thanks.
Number four, consent items. Receive and place on file the following reports for November 2015. Assessor, registered deeds, clerk of the district court, and county clerk.
I would move approval of the consent items.
Second.
It's moved and seconded that we approve the consent items. Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number five is public comment. Those wishing to speak on items relating to county business not on agenda may do so at this time.
Seeing none, let's move forward.
Number six is announcements. The Lancaster County Board of Commissioners will not hold a staff meeting on Thursday, December 10th, 2015. Due to the board's attendance at the Nebraska Association of County Officials annual conference in Kearney, Nebraska, the next regularly scheduled staff meeting will be on Thursday, December 17th at 8:30 a.m. in the Bill Luxford studio of the County City Building. The Lancaster County Board of Commissioners will hold their next regular meeting on Tuesday, December 15th, 2015 at 9 a.m. in room 112 of the County City Building, with the Board of Equalization immediately following. County Commissioners can be reached at 402-441-7447 or commish@lancaster.ne.gov. The Lancaster County Board of Commissioners meeting is broadcast live. It is rebroadcast on Tuesday and Saturday on 5 City TV, cable channel 5. In addition, the meeting may be viewed on the internet at lancaster.ne.gov under 5 City TV Video On Demand or 5 City TV on YouTube.
Move we adjourn.
Second.
Moved and seconded that we adjourn. Please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0.
Okay, the Board of Commissioners meeting is adjourned, and let's move on now to the Board of Equalization.
A copy of the Nebraska Open Meetings Act is located on the wall at the rear of the hearing room. Additionally, a copy of all written material to be discussed at today's open meeting is available from the county clerk's staff. The material can also be viewed on the county's website at lancaster.ne.gov. Also in attendance this morning is Scott Gaines from the county assessor's office. Agenda item one are minutes. Approve the minutes of the Board of Equalization meeting held on Tuesday, December 1st, 2015.
Move approval.
Second.
Moved and seconded that we approve the minutes of last week's meeting. Are there any corrections? Please call the roll.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number two is a public hearing for motor vehicle tax exemption applications, and this is for Christian Heritage Children's Homes and Tabitha Inc.
Okay, we'll open the public hearing for this. Is there anyone speaking in support of these exemption applications, in opposition to, or in a neutral position? And seeing none, I will close the public hearing.
I would move approval of the motor vehicle tax exemption applications.
Second.
Move and second that we approve the motor vehicle tax exemption applications. Please call the roll. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number three is notice of assessed valuation change for property taxation purposes, and this is for Robert and Connie Duchesne, and they have two notices.
These are just the corresponding notices for the issue we just addressed.
Right. Is there action we need to take, or is this just information?
I think we want to approve these are the value changes that the board can take, so we would need to approve those, and then they'll be sent out, and just like any other value notice, they've got a 30-day window to appeal that.
Okay. Move approval of the notice.
Second.
It's moved and seconded that we approve the notice of assessed valuation changes. Any discussion? Please call the roll.
Shore?
Yes.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0. Number four is public comment. Sorry. Those wishing to speak on items relating to County Board of Equalization business, not on agenda, we do so at this time.
Seeing none, let's move towards adjournment.
I move we adjourn.
Second.
Moved and seconded that we adjourn. Please call the roll.
Wilchin?
Yes.
Avery?
Yes.
Shore?
Yes.
Amundson?
Yes.
Motion carries 4-0.
And the Board of Equalization is adjourned. All righty.